Fiddly ping. Welcome back, folks. More 7 days to die. I was just in the pause menu and I'm carrying on recording straight from the previous episode where we smashed up the horde again. So I haven't been able to change the difficulty setting yet because I haven't exited and come back in. But I will do it before we get to the next horde. I'll probably do it before I do the next recording session. Yeah, we'll need to do repairs. Still got plenty of fuel in there, so I'm not going to worry about that. No need to refuel that yet. And there's certainly plenty of ammunition still in them. I dumped my hammer and my repair stuff, didn't I? Right, okay, let's go and empty this lot out first. Yeah, I'm already moving slow because of carrying all this extra stuff. Oh, no, not that one. That one. Dump that one, not that one. There's not a lot to go in here, really. It's all mainly other parts. I need to change out my tools now that I found those better tools. And then I want to go and see if we can get a decent mission from the trader now that we're up to tier 3. Yeah, I don't really want them. Rather have the red tea, thanks. Is that large beef as a recipe? Got more coffee. Probably do with making some more red tea. And need food as well anyway, so use one of them now. Keep the peas. You got to keep the peas. Yeah, otherwise you'll get into trouble if you don't keep the peas. Sorry. It's just silly time. Yeah, we'll definitely swap that for that. And I think we're going to be swapping that for that as well. Very much doubt that it's not as good. Yeah, a little bit better. Not a whole lot, but a little bit better. And it's got an extra slot in it, even though I don't exactly have anything to use for that slot. Oh yeah, the others are in the box, aren't they? Right. I suppose them should go in the horde medical box. Nothing else in here. They got a dye in them, yeah, brown. Who wears brown tinted goggles? Are the ones who got on +4? I thought they were only +3. Oh, that's alright then. That's definitely for selling. And that, and that. You find in bits like the same as other clothing, you know, you'll find a top and leggings and gloves and whatever for a hazmat suit. And if you really, really want to, I think, no good picking on the picture, you fool. If you really, really want to, you can keep them, and it will give you the ability to go to, of course, I haven't explored that far yet. You can go to the very edge of the map, because a certain distance out from the very edge of the map, it starts getting radiated. So you can't, you know, can't survive there for very long without a hazmat suit. And I think there might be one or two other locations that you'd find in the game where there's a bit of radiation. So there's sort of a use for the hazmat suit, but it's not really something you'd need to keep. Unless you want, like, in like a completionist kind of fashion, you want to have just, you know, one of everything. I thought I had more of those fort bites. I don't usually bother using them at all, so I was going to just put them with the others if I had some. The goggles I'm still wearing. Yeah, they are plus four. I thought they were only plus three. I suppose could be useful. I've just never really found that it makes that much of a difference that there's any point constantly carrying them around with you. And if you're wearing the nerdy specs, it's just an annoyance to have to constantly swap them over for the sake of a tiny little bit of difference that they make, because they don't seem to make much difference. Do that first. It took what, 34 seconds. Okay, actually, considering I've already had one red tea, so I'll do that now. Have even more shotgun ammo. I'll try and make a beeline for any even half decent shotgun in the trader, if he happens to have one, even if he wants a few thousand for it. I think it's about time in the game, considering the amount of ammunition I went through using just the machine gun, and that tier one pistol now is pretty much useless unless it's against the like lowest level of zombies. So I could do with a shotgun now, and it is somewhat annoying to have that amount of ammunition building up like that and there's not really anything I can do with it. No, that's just smelter gubbins. Don't really need that just at the moment. Oh dear. Got the sneezes now as well. Be gone, demon. Still haven't found any sugar butts, but sugar butt. Might as well get rid of all this lot. It's not exactly worth a super amount. It's not like I'm wasting really high level items that would be, you know, a massive boost in value if I put a mod into them. These items are all somewhat low value. That's gonna consume repair kits, isn't it? I might as well, I've got enough. How much longer? A few seconds, I thought it might only be a few seconds. I need to make some more repair kits again. Seem to be going through a lot of repair kits. Can't be the last iron. Did I still have some more in here, I think? Yeah. Even just one repair kit, so that I'm not running around with any at all. That in there for now. Sugar butts would be really good right now. Hopefully we can find more vending machines en route to a mission location. Because I think being tier 3 is more likely going to send me further into the town area. Oh well. Not exactly much point buying skull crushers. Not at the moment anyway, while I'm just doing
the
general.
Apocalypse isn't so bad.
Oh, I'm sure you're making loads of money, mate, so it must be good for you. Yes, tier 3. Restore power. No, thank you. Clear zombies. That's quite close by.
Can you do me a favor?
A farm. I doubt I'm going to find a...
Great. I look forward to seeing you again.
A beaker at a farm, but I'll try anywhere at the moment and just keep repeating the quests. And of course he's updated jar of honey for 240. I think I will once I've finished checking through. See, there's the hazmat suit. You can keep it, mate, it's useless. Plus 3. I'm going to sell you some of them in a minute. And I must remember to sell the higher tier helmets before the lower tier, in case he gets fed up with them and won't buy any more. Nothing really of interest so far. I could buy ammunition, but he's got a good amount of casings and tips. And it's tempting to buy the pipe bombs until I can figure out the recipe. Only 40 gunpowder. You know, I can see me buying just a lot of little bits and bobs. Veggie stew? No, thank you. A tier 6 football helmet. Tier 1 steel armor. Come on, you have something worthwhile. Military armor schematic? Nah. I almost never make them. Bloody hell, that's the first one I've seen. It's day blooming 29, and that's the first pocket mod I've seen. And it's only a 1. I think I will be buying that, but. And a tier 3 pump shotgun. 10 grand, blooming hell. Till day 31. Tier 3 steel chest armor would be good as well, but find more gems in loot. I thought I already had that one. Getting confused. Must be getting confused with a different game or a different map. Okay. Well, there's one or two bits you've got, mate, that I will buy. But for now, even without the sugar butts, what do you give me for them? You will give me 50 for them. Are you going to have all of them? No, I thought you might get fed up of them. Alright, so tier 5 and the 4s. Probably now. Okay, have the silly shoes. And all of that, what's that worth? 240. I wonder if I buy the wood splitter mod is 6 foot now, sod it. I just let the money trickle up for now, and I worry about min-maxing stuff like that another time. Right, the jar of honey I'll have. And what else was there? There was gunpowder and bullet-making stuff. What's that, 690? I've got a ton of brass in the smelter. I don't really need to buy them. The pipe bombs. Yeah, no. It's just a bit too much to expend that amount of money on when it's things that you can find in general loot anyway. It's not as if you're never going to see them again. already had the honey, and I don't think he had anything else apart from the pocket mud. And first pocket mud to find, and I've got to actually pay for it. That's just terrible. Yeah.
Y'all come back now.
But at least I finally got one. The first pocket mud. One better. Okay, let's find where this quest is. Because I'm not worried about doing the 3 kilometer drive yet. Oh, well, it's that one just down there. That's the one with the big barn. And the pig in the field, I think. So we'll get some more meat out of it. As long as I make sure I don't get myself infected again. I'll sort of leave the bike there for 2 seconds. Go and drop off this stuff that I've just purchased. And gunpowder for you. Oh, nice twitch. You can have that. One of the reasons that it would be worth going to find the other trader is I could sell this stuff that he wouldn't buy. And I've got an okay amount of money for this level, for the level that I'm at, so yeah, I could potentially find some things that would be useful at the moment. I need to do the little bits of repairing that need doing after the hoard, but other than that, the main concern at the moment, I need to gather the harvesting as well at some point. It's not exactly like a rush for that. I've got plenty already. What I need. Oh. Drop it now. Oh, you dropped it all the way back there. How far back there? Not too far. Oh, yeah, let's do this mission first. I have found a beaker in a drop box before, so there's a possibility that drop box could have a beaker in it. But I want to get this done first so that we're not caught out being at night time again. And I should be able to cope all right with it with the stuff I've got now. But we're starting to get. Oh, I haven't actually been in this one before. I thought I had. We are starting to get to the stage where I need to improve my equipment to keep up with the level of threat that we're going up against. You know, the zombies are getting a little bit harder, taking a bit longer to kill with the equipment I've currently got. And they're doing a bit more damage to me because my armour can't quite cope with it anymore. What's there, a letterbox? A mailbox. Yeah, all the way up there. Just to be cheesy, I've got to run all the way across the field. And it's one I already know. Okay. What? Hopefully when it respawns it'll be one. I don't know. Any nests in this field? I'm just trying to cheese it and grab what I can before it gets refreshed. When I activate the quest. The quest, mission, task, job. I'm sure you can call it lots of different things. The money earner. Okay. There's a kennel there. Does that mean we're going to have a doggy? Where could the doggy be? If he's not out here. Are you in the basement? Have you fallen over? Do you need me to help you get up again? Oh, okay, just the mailbox then by the looks of it. And we get another one I've already read. Okay. Let's try this door. Is this one locked? Yeah. I wonder if you're meant to go in through the barn or are they not connected in any way? Let's have the free wood. Because that's what Edward Woodward would do. That door's locked. What about this one? Okay then, Mr. Level Designer. Ah, there's a railing. So it's a climbing one. Okay. Yeah, there's even a torch there, look, to give you a clue. They usually leave a light source somewhere near the pathway they're expecting you to follow. Hello, love. Are you snoozing? Oh, you're losing. Ba-dum-tsh. Oh, no, it's a cupboard. Not more clothes. I've seen far too many clothes with that blooming clothing store. Don't need to see more clothing. Not unless it's lingerie. Although then again, lingerie on a zombie, yeah, that wouldn't be nice. Not unless you're a bit freaky. I'd like to see your zombies wearing lingerie. Yeah, I thought it might be. So we're supposed to go up and over the top, okay. Oh, come on, get up the stairs. Here's the nest. I was looking outside, you know, where you'd think there would be a nest. That's an unusual box. There is some bits of cobblestone in here as well that I wonder. I suppose I could use the spear. That's got the same reach as the shovel. Oh, there you are. Have one of them. One of them. And then you can both have that. There you go. Don't bother getting up. Told you. An abrasion. How dare you. Here. Hannah. Hannah Fry. Are you frying tonight? Oh, you were. You know, a bit overdone and crispy. So, what were they doing in here, I wonder? Just the two of them. Just the two of them. They're the zombies that can't die. Just the two of them. Nothing in your pipe? That's no good. I've got something in my pipe. I use my burning wood to light it. Here we have flaming pipe as well as flaming wood. There were the grab bags around, loot containers. No. Oh, that's wood. I thought that was a window. Looks like a window. Okay. Bit of an odd hole in the ceiling. Definitely don't remember this POI, this location. Don't know if I've ever been in here before. Oh, what's in your cabinet? Oh, just some creamy stuff. Can I take your pee water? No, just you use toilet paper. Not wake anyone up? No? Not surprised. Oh, I see ya. Oh, stay on the floor. Don't bother getting up. He wasn't happy about it. Yeah, I get the clue, you're supposed to go out the window. There's a lot of in and out in with this location. Yeah. There doesn't seem to be much in the way of loot containers. We got any flappies? Any flappers flapping around? No? This must be one of the newer maps then. Because those posters were only included after a certain alpha, I can't remember which one. But they've not been in the game that long. Well, depends on your definition of time. Because it's been however many years since they did the last major update. It's a good game. I really, you know, been playing it for years. I like the game. It's just they're so slow to develop it. It's... Oh! Didn't see you coming out the wall. Well, that's probably the point, wasn't it? Somebody else behind me, get out of my way, love. Coming through. I heard you. Trying to sneak up on me. Get down. And you. Oh. Yeah, definitely need a better bat. Definitely need a better lighter. That one gone out again. Right, so can't get in it from above, so I'm guessing you meant to jump through that gap. Can I do it? Got no parkour skills yet. I still haven't spent my skill points. Terrible for that. I keep trying to remember to spend them and I just stop pissing about and use a step for goodness sake. All of this, I bet it's just a bit of pee in the toilet and that's it, isn't it? Oh, it's just more poo paper. A few vitamins which can be useful. I tend to keep them to use them on horde night, as I did in the previous episode, because they just help give you that protection against getting infected when you're fighting the horde. It's no good. I need to know what's behind here. Get iron from smashing up a tyre, really. That was the way I came in, wasn't it? Yeah, so I could have done that right from the start. Okay. Let's grab this now. Secure an inventory slot to keep it in. I'm just going to scrap stuff like that for now. Got zero use for it. Okay, whatever, that'll do. No, that's the way I came in, wasn't it? So we're going down the stairs. Now that we've done the up and over. Hello! It's Mr. Noisemaker. I'm making loads of noise. Just to try and get your attention. Oh, I hear ya. One or two of you by the sound. Two. One for you. Where's your mate? Stuck in the corner. Get that out of the way. Oh, it's Liz. Have you resigned again, Liz? You resigned to being part of the flooring. Oh. Yeah, I think I know what she was saying. Sister. Ah, that's a half open door that's asking to be broken down. Any more bookshelves in here? There's been a few bookshelves so far. Well, there is, but they're all empty. Well, that's crap. That's poo. But there is a safe. I'll give it one try because I've got a few lockpicks. But I'm not going to waste loads of them. If it comes to it, I can always come back again with some lockpicking candies. Yeah. Leave it for another time. It's only a small safe. I doubt there'll be anything majorly good in it. And my baseball bat is almost toasted. So I'm going to need to use up that repair kit. No little. Oh, that's not too bad. It's not the heavier one, the armour plating one, but it's still, I think, adds plus one. Oh, I wouldn't know without being able to make one. Look at it next time I'm back at the base. More spam. Liquids, might as well use that now. What's in your microwave? Some nasty shit. It's all somewhat useful, but not really. I hope there's some decent loot at the end of this, because there hasn't really been much to loot so far. An empty shopping basket just there on the side, okay. I think I'll use my repair kit now. I'm sure I could hear somebody knocking on a wall or something somewhere. Did I guess he's going to be under the stairs? No, come back. There you go. You can have one as well, you're right. Oh. Some more cobblestone. Nothing in there. Oh man. Is this some kind of game revenge? Because this is the first place I've looted after destroying the horde. Here, sounds like you might be upstairs. Well, let's carry on down here because they might be round this corner. Yeah, in there by the looks of it. Oh, and in here. Come on then, one at a time. Right, knock. No, you can't come in. Knock. I said no. Knock. No Jehovah's Witnesses. Yeah, that might be a bunch of wandering zombies upstairs, I think, maybe. Definitely an interesting amount of noise going on up there. Oh, that's the same one. Ah, that's those locked doors. And I guess that means that, yeah. Right, let's see if they are up here. They're inside. I think. Ah, there they are. Hi, guys. You gonna get up? I said no. I see ya. Bunk for you. Any more? No, right. So I can carry on. Well, thank you. You're so gracious. While I'm encumbered and having to move slowly. Having to walk all the way back round again. I definitely have to chop all of this. And wasn't there another little one somewhere yet? Anything in there? Oh, it sounds like there's more on their way. I'll deal with them when they get here. All these empty bookshelves. Oh man, I think there's possibly a wandering horde that had turned up, which happens fairly often when you're trying to explore somewhere. Missed by miles. Stand still, love, and let me shoot you. Thank you. Okay. I think if there's any more turn up, I'll let them just follow me down here. I don't want to keep going back to try and protect my back passage. Ooh. This is very tunnely. I like the way they've done these beams. Ooh. Don't like the way he's looking at me. I am not for dinner. Definitely needs a better melee weapon there. Is there anything under there? No. Don't think so. I wonder if this goes to the barn then. Looks like it. Generator in here, so it's a... restore power quest. The location is a restored power location, so that must have been when they added this POI, when they did that update. This is a bit of a cornering. Oh. Come and put your head where my bullet is. Hey! Hey! You just didn't like my toes. Right, let's get all the way over here. Let's see if we've got any other spawning over here. No. They must all be outside then. All right, the last time I was in a barn, I ended up with a broken leg. So let's try and not do the same thing. I'm already moving slow enough. I don't want a broken leg as well. That was completed the quest. Right, okay. Let's hurry up and get the loot then. That's not loot. That's just crap. Across the beam. It's not a collapsy beam, is it? I bet this has got collapsing shit in it. They seem to like doing that to me recently. I did run. Oh, pea water. Just what I always wanted. Can't see anything in there. I didn't encounter any dog either. Even though there was the kennels. Okay. And is there any... No, there's no bales of hay down there. So you can't exactly bale out the window. More pea water. And... It's not whiskey in a jar, oh. I can hear you. Have you found your way to me yet? Nearly. Let's see if I can save some ammunition. I know the arrows count as ammunition, but it's a... Oh, you cheeky... There you go, in the back of the head. Yeah, I was going to say, it's less cost in terms of resources. The bolts, rather than ammunition proper. That's it, love. You wiggle your way along there. Oh, a blue bag, thank you. Right, let's hurry up and get this done then so we can... see what's in that blue bag. Oh, they... See, made me wiggle my way around there and I'm going to end up just using blocks anyway because I'm not doing any jumping across that. Not when I'm moving so slow anyway. Oh, a pipe pistol. Oh dear, chicken soup has no recipe. Get in my belly. I'll have that crappy pipe pistol. Got any decent medication? No, okay, I might leave that behind. I'll decide when I see what else is here. Scrap. Can't exactly carry it anyway. I could take them. Have that. Put that in there for now. Oh, Dirty Harry. What do we get? Oh yeah, that's a good one. Could do with the one that gives you the trading bonus. I'll tell you what, let's dump that in there. That's crap. And 7 feathers can sod off. I really don't want more feathers. Shotgun Messiah, give me a shotgun Messiah. The fucking shit. They do an alright amount of damage, but they're just too slow. Is there something under there or not? No. Okay, so it's just this one locked box. Let's see if I can get it open. I've only got a handful of lockpicks. But if it's a super easy lock, hopefully, we can get to that 1 second. There you go. If you get below 1 second, it's guaranteed to open, basically. Recover one hit with every punch. That's all right. That's a good one. There's the beaker. That's not too bad, actually. That's quite a good little selection. So what can we get rid of? We can have 2 cornmeal and 23 sand. absolutely want that. That can go straight in the AK if there's space. I don't think there is. Is there? No, there's only two slots. I suppose I could put it on there. I suppose just put it in there for now so that it's not. What did you do then? Did you press the wrong key again? I think I did. There. That one. Alright, just so it saves a slot. Still gonna need one more space. You sandwich can sod off. Right. I would say let's go the quick way down, but I'm not gonna risk it. And slow enough as it is, I don't want a broken leg. It's just gonna take blooming ages to get back. I'm not going to be able to get back in time to get the trader now either. That blue bag is still there, that's what I wanted. That's not too bad. The fibre sells for quite a bit. And I think the steroids is worth more than a bit of paper. Pea water? Yay, more pea water. Don't worry guys, I'll be out there to help you in a moment. I'm sure there might be a few more bits and pieces in here yet. Just the back door, okay. No, I think that was it on the inside. One little box of rubbish. Wow. You're right, you can keep it. Let's just get out of here. Oh. That was a lot of good, them giving you the key to get out, but then you're locked in anyway. It's like, yeah, you can open one door, but not the other. One door, not the other. You're gonna be locked in. Don't care. Oh, hello, Hannah. Hannah Fry. Now you die. Yeah. I broke a way in anyway. Where are you? I can hear you. I see ya. Stop beating up that hay bale. Give me some fraying tonight. Okay. See, even then, when I knew I like needed to get in here, because otherwise we wouldn't be finished before the end of the daytime, and close. That's what, about 30 seconds in real time, anyway, 30 seconds into the night. Oh, don't touch me. I'm riding me back. Don't want to be touched by you while I'm riding me back. Yeah. I was hoping to get it done with just enough time to go back to the trader, but no. Oh well, that'll be something to hand in tomorrow, get some experience to get maybe some more skill points that I'll forget to spend. But instead, we can hide away in a hidey hole. Yeah, it's not exactly hidden, you know. You know, big installation. Alright. Let's do food stuff first before he starts complaining about it. still need to gather the next harvest in, don't I? But not exactly any rush for that. What's that worth? Oh, blooming hell. Could have scrapped that rather than carting that crapper in. That'll be for sale. Whether to keep that, it fires 9 mil, it's doing 42 damage, that's on a par with the AK. If I could find a suppressor, that'd be fairly useful for stealth killing. Yeah, I think I'll keep that and repair it. That could prove to be quite effective as a 9 mil weapon. The SMG is obviously the better 9mm weapon. I'm not sure if they've changed the ammunition though or not in this latest alpha update. Now I can't remember if they had switched it to 7.62 instead. Oh, have we already got a few? Yeah, I thought so. We've now got plenty enough acid. Yeah, I might as well keep the acid on me because I know I'm going to want it for making the chemistry station. Shit, need 100 iron. I've spent all the iron on those darts. I suppose I could smelt them in. They're not exactly worth a major amount, it's hardly worth anything. Or I could go and do some nighttime mining. Wouldn't take long to get enough iron. What we're gonna need, what's our cost of... I keep clicking that one, it's that one. We're running at 11. Per unit. So I'd need at least 110. That's not a lot. I'm not far off it already. Let's see what we can scavenge together before I bother going out to try doing nighttime mining. It's not that it's impossible, it's just taking a fair bit of a risk. If I can do it without needing to take that risk, then obviously that's the better option. Because even though I don't want the game, the video content, I don't want the video to be boring of me just, you know, constantly being super cautious, sneaking around everywhere and trying to just ultimately stay alive. I know that's the principle of the game, but you can overdo it. You can build yourself a column in the middle of the wilderness and just stand on top of it and never go anywhere. I want the content to be at least somewhat interesting, but at the same time I'm still playing the game as if I was playing the game properly anyway, so I would rather my character stays alive. Right, let's just compare that. I don't think it's not better than that's unfortunate considering. Why is it telling me plus 7 there? Oh, so it is actually plus 7 better. Okay. But it's only going to have one mod slot on it. I suppose that can move to somewhere else. I only really need the headlamp on it for now. What do you need to repair? Iron... No, an actual repair kit, for which I will need iron. Do I need any other repair kits? No. While I'm here, grab the other iron bits. We'll see if we can get enough. No, no duct tape in there. So we will make some. Make two of them. And then give us two of them. I'll use one to repair the iron helmet. And then keep the other one as my backup repair kit anyway. Similar to these other items, I like to make sure I've got one repair kit with me, so that when all your something important gets broken, then obviously you've got a repair kit to use on it. That and that, thank you. And we will only have the headlamp in it now. And we will now have the stupid iron helmet look. Whee! Look, I'm wearing some kind of 1920s gas mask helmet or something. Okay, so we have repair kit. I'm just double checking myself before I start doing anything else. Yeah, I'll keep that just in case. That's got both its slots full. So is that. That one hasn't. Right. You can have that in there. Do I already have them in there? Yes, I do. Okay. It's worth 160 at the moment. I'll more than likely end up just cashing them in. In which case, I might as well stick them in the for sales box. And they can be steadily building up until I go and sell them. I've never tried doing this. Can you actually smelt armour pieces? I think you can. Yes, you can. I see it. Yes, you can. Alright. And while we're waiting, let's make a few more duct tape for in the box. Yeah, that'll do. Yeah, five of them. Them away. Carrying one med kit, probably from yesterday after the horde. So we've got that. Oh, I could smelt that stupid thing as well. All of this for a chemistry station. 102, is that all it got out of that? I'll have to put that in as well. Have I massively miscalculated? It takes 11 to make each one. Yeah, I have. I need 1,000 iron, or 1,100 iron, I should say, not 110. You dummy. That would only be 10 forged iron, not 100. So we're not going to get anywhere near it with that. So we are instead going to put that just there for now. I'll put that in the sales box, but I won't actually sell it yet. That should be in the ammunition box. And let's repair the pipe machine gun. Yeah, 42.5. That's not too bad. Let's have that out. What's that? Semi-auto mod. I'm not sure if you'd be able to put it in there. Let's find out. Yes, you can. I said, can you? And I said, yes, you can. We've got one of them. Anything else appropriate for a machine gun? What's that? Burst mod. Yeah, no, I think it would It's better with the semi-auto on. No. 48.6 for a 9mm, yeah, that's quite useful. No, it's using 7.62. Not 9mm. Is that right? Yeah, 7.62. Damn you, poo face! That's what we're getting off that, 53. That's getting 48.6. Give us that back. Well, actually, you can keep that and you can go in the sales box. Put that back in you. Oh well, it was worth a check. But considering it's using the 7.62 instead, there's no point me keeping it. I'll leave that down there so that hopefully I'll remember. Now it's a bit late to go and get more iron there. Well, I'll just have to do it next time. Unfortunately. Put the pipes back in there. Let's stick that in there so I remember to sell them. Right then, where did I put my hammer? Where did I put my hammer? Right here with the hoard stuff then. Yeah. I'll do a little bit of hammering to finish the day off or finish the night time off. I had all this iron in there as well, but still nowhere near enough. I'll have to wait until I go and do some mining. We've got the quest reward to hand in as well, so we will have a little chunk of experience and money. Done most of this in here really. That's not damaged, tiny bit there. Again, they're not even really one point. It's not even really worth me doing it yet. Be better waiting until it's a bit more damaged. Let's go up on the roof and see if the vultures did much damage, a little bit. But hardly anything. Okay. Make that a bit more rigid. It's a morning dawn time again. Just enough time to do some fruit picking, well, veggie picking. Potato. No coffee seeds at all. Well, chrysanthemum, a little bit missing. I think I've got some in the box. Let's go and see what I've got in my box first. Corn, one of them. I've got no more potato seeds left. One pumpkin seed. I'll take it with me in case I need it. We'll have to make the other seeds. Start with the corn. And need one potato seed. Key. The shift key, not the control key. Couple of them. Didn't get any coffee seeds. That only leaves me with three coffee. Still slowly builds up. Only one hops and I'm missing a pumpkin. Maybe the vultures ate one of my pumpkins. So we need one of them. And we've only got the one pumpkin seed. So the seeds didn't do that well this time. But overall we still made... we made a profit in terms of the produce produced, which is the way it should be working. So our infinite food supply will continue, and mushrooms as well. Probably don't need six up there. And it's only given me three seeds. There's one seed in there, yeah, so let's just do four. Considering I'm not making loads of the mushroom based stuff. Normally it's just the steak and potato meal that I make that uses mushrooms. As far as I remember, where is it? Yeah. There aren't any of the others that I'm making that will be using mushrooms now, so we don't need like six of them growing. I'm already up to 64 mushrooms, so that's plenty. Unfortunately, they're not the magic kind, so there's no point me like having tons of them. Right, that was at least we got the mission done. There's a drop box out there waiting for me to collect it. And we got the chemistry, the stuff required to make the chemistry station. I just need to grab a bit more iron next time and get those 100 iron bars back again, and then we'll be good with the chemistry station. So it's ticking along nicely. And we got plenty of ammunition in the dart traps and all that good stuff. We just need to get some more gun ammunition. A shotgun or something, you know, another firearm I think is needed. So we'll be looking for that next time. Thanks again for watching, folks. We'll catch you again soon. Catches.